My name's Bill Miller. I'm a 90-year-old ex-World War II ski trooper. I live in Sisters, Oregon. The National Ski Patrol, before World War II, the head of it was a really aggressive guy who had been looking at pictures, news pictures, of the war in Finland between the Russians and the Finns. And it was the Finnish ski troopers, all camouflaged in white in the forest, who defeated much larger Russian armies who were overrunning their country. And he felt the U.S. should have a division that was trained to work in the mountains, to climb mountains, to live outdoors under Arctic conditions. And so he finally persuaded the Defense Department, which was then I think the War Department, to put together a mountain division. And they did. Started out with one regiment, the 87th Regiment, and then they built a camp up near Leadville, Colorado, and they formed another, a second regiment, the 86th, and then they formed a third, the 85th Mountain Infantry Regiment, of which I was a part, and trained at Camp Hale. And when I became draft age, and I came from a skiing family, and knew that there was a ski troop division, I volunteered, and even though I was only 5'7 and weighing 113 pounds or something, I volunteered and was accepted. That was in 1943, and I spent the next year and a half training in the mountains, living outside, living sometimes in our sleeping bags at 45 below out in the mountains, until we went overseas in late 1944. These are all taken during training. That's Private Miller in his uniform. And this is the rucksack, which is the pack that we always carried, and my rifle. And this is just on some maneuver. A friend of mine had a camera. Here I am at a machine gun, again, during some maneuvers. And he was a bit artistic and just took a couple of skis against the mountains in the background. Well, the hat is a military hat that is worn by the Italian mountain troops, the Alpini. And it's called the Cappella d'Alpini, Alpina hat, with a black feather, which is always in their hats. And so the penna nera, the black feather, and the Cappella d'Alpini. And I'm very lucky to have it. It's extremely rare. Italian mountain troops are a very proud group of people. And they to give their hats away to somebody is really very, very unusual. After the war in Europe ended, we were sent on occupation duty along the Yugoslav border, and we set up a mountain climbing school. So we were there for some weeks, and I had been practicing my Italian and got to know a family nearby, and their son had been an Italian mountain trooper who supported us in combat. He and a number of other of their soldiers gave support to our mule trains, which is the only way we could get supplies up the mountain. We didn't have vehicles that could do it. And so we had really fought in similar battles and got very friendly. Family kind of adopted me. I was there for almost a month. And it was a very sad parting when we left. And we exchanged gifts. And I had picked up from one of the partisans, the mountain partisans, a throwing knife, which I used to carry in my back belt, which had a loop on it. You could pull it out and fling it. And he really envied that knife. And so I gave him the knife as a parting present, and he gave me his hat. So this is a bona fide Italian mountain trooper's hat, which has itself been in combat and belonged to a very dear and close friend. So the hat's very special to me, and I often wear it skiing.